Tajveer is saying, what roles do examples, ideals, role models play in this process of conditioning? They play a very, very important role. They play an extremely important role. Since childhood, there are these great images that have been given to us. And those images are being constantly drilled into our mind by the society, by the media, by family, by education. And it is being told to us that this is what is worth following. And this process is especially severe upon a small child, very, very severe. You see, we said mind is brain plus intelligence, but there is something that we have missed out on, which is that brain and intelligence are not two watertight compartments, not two separate compartments. The brain itself is the seat of intelligence. The brain is not intelligent, but the brain is the seat of intelligence. If the brain is not adequately developed or damaged, intelligence won't operate. For example, in animals, because the brain is not adequately developed, hence there is no question of intelligence. Similarly, in a child, because you don't have yet enough gray matter up there, so discretion, free will can't be there. So the child is dependent. He has to take knowledge, information from outside, and he's exploited. Instead of the minimal information that the child must be given for his development, he is instead handed over a lot of beliefs. Even before you can open your eyes, a religion is handed over to you. A nationality is handed over to you. And you have no say in that. Role models are handed over to you. Along with the nation comes the father of the nation. And you are told a role model. And all that goes a long distance in conditioning the mind. Yes.